Hi, there is an art show that I would love you folks to attend. I'm going to give you the dates and the time and the place, and then I'm going to introduce some of the folks that are involved in the art show. The art show is called The Spirit Within, and it's being held at the Holy Trinity Church, which is in West Harwich. The dates are August 25th, 26th, 27th, and 28th. We'll give you times and some other information later on. There's an opening reception Thursday evening from 4 to 6, but before we get into the nitty-gritty of that, I've got three wonderful folks here I would like you to meet. First, Carol Sifko, who is organizing and helping with the art show.
That's great. Mm-hmm.
What's your name? Bill Maloney. Bill Maloney, a very well-known artist and a very nice person. And Bob Johnson, a most artistic sculptor and a very, very nice person also. Carol, give us an idea of how this fundraiser, because this is a fundraiser from what I'm told, for a crucifix, a Holy Trinity crucifix that Bob has sculpted. Give us an idea how this fundraiser came about.
Well, Bob and I started talking to one another one day. In fact, it was outside of our chapel and in back of the Holy Trinity Church. And we discovered we were both artists. Bob was is a sculptor. I'm an oil painter. And we started talking about the work that he had done, the fabulous work that he had been working on for 5 years. He has done the sculpture in his studio at home, and it is being bronzed, and it's completed now and ready to be on display as for the dedication in September.
Oh.
And so I spoke to Bob, and I said, well, you know, I do religious art. Lately I've been doing spiritual art, something that's been around since the caveman, but it's a little different for Cape Cod. And I thought, well, I'd love to have a show and show some art that comes within each person, comes from within each person inside of them. And the main thing that I thought about was Bob's crucifix that he had done. And then we have other work, my work, and work that other artists have done in the community. We have 20 artists that are going to be at this show. Mm-hmm. And they're going to be showing work that they have done, something that they're going to take the spirit from within them. It's not really religious art, but it's spiritual art in mm-hmm. a way. And it might be a scene of Cape Cod. It might be a person. It might be something that is very unique from that particular artist. And
A good example of the artwork that you're talking about is a work that Bill Maloney, and is that oil?
Yeah, that's an oil painting.
Tell us briefly about that.
Well, the reason I did this in the first place was that there was no representation of how the back of the church with the crucifix was going to look.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of like a triple header out here. We have the chapel, Adoration mm-hmm. Chapel, the crucifix in the middle, which will have little benches and mm. people can come up and sit around. And with the donation, people will have their names on a little wall here. And mm-hmm. then the columbarium.
Mm-hmm.
So it's kind of adds, connects both of them together. And it was just an oil painting of the scene and what it looks like.
Bob, how did the concept of this Holy Trinity crucifix come about overnight?
Well, it all started with Father Healy. And Father Healy mentioned to me that he had the memorial wall there and needed a crucifix, which you need in a Christian burial spot. So he commissioned me to do this work, which has taken about 5 years.
Wow.
So I've been working diligently and helping out, and here
we are.
Can
you give us a synopsis of how the crucifix, how you went about sculpting this crucifix? And folks, after it's sculpted, it's bronzed. Give us a little.
Okay. Well, we all remember baby booties being bronzed.
Oh, yeah.
But that process was literally to paint a metal paint on a baby shoe, and that was called bronze. Well, put that away from our minds at this point, because the process is the ancient lost wax process which the Greeks and the Romans used. We still use it today. I use an art foundry called New England Sculpture Center up mm-hmm. in Chelsea, Mass.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm going to briefly try to do five quick steps on how you get from my finger mm-hmm. in flesh to another finger in bronze. So first of all, the artist creates in his studio a physical representation, in this case of this finger. So you'd take a lump of clay and you'd look at your finger and you'd look at the clay and you'd work back and forth and come up with a clay representation of your finger, maybe put it on a stand and admire that.
Yeah.
Well, then you go, then the artist is all done. You then go up to the foundry, and the foundry then takes a mold of it. They put latex on it, back it up with plaster, and make a two-part mold. They split the mold out, and out comes the clay. The clay gets tossed in the dump. In fact, I put all the whole crosses in the Harwich dump now. It's all done. Anyway, next, the foundry takes wax and coats the inside of the mold so that we now become come into a positive of the finger in wax.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. That then goes to another process where they make yet another mold. They dip the wax in ceramic and add sand to it. Eventually they build up a shell around it, like a ceramic shell. So here we have the finger going into an oven, which is high heat, and the ceramic is fused into almost like glass.
Mm.
The wax pours out and is lost.
Lost wax.
Okay, it's gone.
Hey.
One more thing. Let's turn the thing over and put molten bronze at about 2,000 degrees, pour that into the finger. Let it cool, chip away the mold from the outside.
The ceramic
is gone, and here's our bronze finger.
Solid bronze?
Well, it's actually hollow.
Oh, it's hollow.
It's about a quarter of an inch thick. Yeah, that's how it's done.
It's fantastic, isn't it? It really is. You know, folks, if you want to read an artist's blog, which I have read, which goes into more description, which also shows photos of the process as it's been going. HolyTrinityCrucifixFund.org, and go over and hyperlink onto artist's blog, and then you can hyperlink onto photos. It's really intriguing. It really is. Carol, you wanted to read something about the spirit within and what really drew you to come up with the idea of the art show.
Okay, thanks, Betty. I was, like I said, we initially started talking about the work that we have in the community that we would like to have available for people to see and to be part of. And I actually got the idea from, it's from Pope John Paul II, Letter to the Artist. It was from April 4th, 1999. And I got this from the Adoramus Bulletin, actually on the internet. And was drawn to this, and I decided, I did some paintings at home by myself, and I read this and I thought, this is interesting. This is something, this is a painting that I did of the Pope when he was visiting Mother Teresa in Calcutta. And I thought, we live in such an interesting time now that, and these are our people that, that I lived in their time, the time that they lived. And these were some people that I'd like to paint. And this is something that the Pope wrote in this letter. And it has, this is where I got the idea of the spirit within. He said that a fruitful alliance between the gospel and art, which is a very ancient form of art. Every genuine artist intuition goes beyond what the senses perceive and, reaching beneath reality's surface, strives to interpret its hidden mystery. The intuition itself springs from the depths of the human soul, where the desire to give meaning to one's own life is joined by the fleeting vision of beauty and of the mysterious unity of things. All artists experience the unbridgeable gap which lies between the work of their hands, however successful it may be, and the dazzling perfection of the beauty glimpsed in the ardor of the creative moment. What they manage to express in their painting, their sculpting, their creating, is no more than a glimmer of the splendor which flared for a moment before the eyes of their spirit. Mm. And this is something that really inspired us to get going and to share the art that we have, and we'd like to show the rest of the community. We have limited prints, limited edition prints for sale, and beautiful paintings, and a percentage of all our artwork is going towards the crucifix campaign. so that we can all enjoy that. And one of the things I wanted to mention, too, that the crucifix is life-size, isn't it, Bob?
Yes, it's 5'11". That's the that's Jesus' height in this particular rendition.
How did we will have a pictorial display at the art exhibit of the process that Bob has gone through making the crucifix. He is going to have just some of the pictures and the process that he has gone through making it.
Now, how did you encourage or get Bill Maloney to come up with this gorgeous painting? It's so real, so real. If you view the area from right here in the parking lot, how did you get Bill involved?
Well,
how did you get involved?
No, well, I was on the committee with Bob for
the fundraising committee.
But,
that's right. But we needed a visual.
Yeah, we needed a visual, and suddenly I volunteered. But it was the Lord telling me, "You need to volunteer."
The finger.
He does well with the finger. Yeah, but what we're going to do at the fundraiser and on the 25th, we're going to auction off this painting. And I do have another one, too, that
we'll show later.
But my feeling, the Lord gives me the talent, and I got to use it.
Yes.
And I got to give it back.
Yes.
And he zings me every once in a while and says, hey, why don't you do a painting of the crucifix so you know what it's going to look like.
So this will be an auction.
Yes.
Okay.
A raffle, really. I'm sorry. Not a raffle. Auction, but a raffle.
A raffle. And are tickets on sale now, or will they be... that day, or have you come up with that yet, committee?
During the show.
That's right. Mm-hmm. And we have other work being raffled. I did a picture called Gentle Woman, a Madonna and Child, and that will be a limited edition print that will be auctioned. Mm-hmm. And Bill also has another picture that is going to be auctioned of Christ's face.
This is beautiful. I think we have a still of this, or we will get a still of this. But while we're
Don't fall down,
is that oil or is that pastel?
This is watercolor, actually.
Watercolor?
Yeah.
Oh.
In my past life, I used to do watercolor.
I didn't know you did watercolor. That's lovely, Bill.
Well, Bill has been an artist his entire life.
My whole life.
Yeah. I've been an artist
That's
my
a long
entire
time.
Life.
Yeah.
We're long time artists. Yeah.
Yes, I'm sitting with three very talented folks from Harwich. And as I said, at the art show, there will be about 20?
We have 20 artists that will be participating, and they are local artists.
All parishioners.
Parishioners, right. Yes, from Holy Trinity. And we're very happy to have them because they have a following of people that just enjoy their work. And I'm sure people are going to like to see them.
I'm going to repeat the times of the art show and encourage you to hop on down there, because on August 25th, Thursday evening, from 4 to 6, there's an opening reception. Music, light refreshments, socialization, and this is sponsored by the artists and sculptors of Holy Trinity. Paintings, sculptures, glissé prints, which are fantastic to own. Pictorial display of the work, as we said, which in itself is really intriguing and educational. That's what really encouraged me to bring this information to you, the educational information that how this crucifix, Holy Crucifix, came about. Bill, you inspire us really with your paintings, and we are thrilled to have you share your talent with us. After August 25th, you can have a viewing of the paintings Friday and Saturday, August 26th and 27th, 9:30 to 6 p.m., and Sunday, August 28th, 8:30 to 1 p.m. Go online, holytrinitycrucifixfund.org.
Well, just to mention that on Sunday, September the 18th, the Holy Trinity Crucifix will be blessed by Father Healy.
Oh, wonderful.
After the 11 o'clock Mass.
Oh, now that's very interesting. Thanks a lot.